Hi, this is a tutorial on how to find the domain of rational functions. Let's start with definition. The domain of a function is the set of all values of the variable that make the function real, real number. Let's take an example. Let's call it example one. Let fx equal 1 over x. For what values of x? The question is, for what values of x is fx a real number? Here it's easy to see that in this example, all real values of x will make fx real except 0. Why? Because if x equal to 0, if we try to find f of 0, we will say 1 over 0, and 1 over 0 is not a real number. So the domain of this function, it will be all real values except 0. So we put a circle on the 0 here. We take all the values except the 0. This is a representation using the number line. Using interval notation, we will say from minus infinity to zero, open here, because we don't want the zero, union, open again, zero to plus infinity. The zero is excluded when we open the interval at this on these two sides. So this is example number one, which is straightforward. Let's look at another example, example number two. In example number two, let fx be equal to 1 over x minus 2. So again, this is a rational function with numerator 1, denominator x minus 2. So what we are going to do is, since the division by 0 is not allowed, what we are going to do is to find the values of x that makes the denominator equal to 0. How do we do this? By solving the simple equation. We will find that x equal to 2 will make this equal to 0. So the domain again will be all real numbers except what? Except the 2. We put an open circle to exclude the 2, and we say that the domain is all these values except the 2. Interval notation, negative infinity to 2. Again, it's open here. Union, open again, 2 plus infinity. Now, let's go to another, to example three. Is equal to 2x plus 1 over x2 plus 3x minus 4. Now, let's find the values that makes this denominator equal to 0. How? By setting the denominator equal to 0 and then solving this quadratic equation. This can be done, for example, by factoring. X plus 4, x minus 1. Let's check. X 2, 4x minus x gives you your 3x, and 4 by times negative 1 gives you the minus 4. So x equal minus 4 and x equal to 1 are two values that will make your denominator equal to 0. If the denominator equal to 0, fx is not real, so they have to be excluded from the number line. The smallest one is minus 4 on the left, the largest one is 1 on the right. We take all values, all real numbers except the negative 4 and the 1. Interval notation will be negative infinity, negative 4. Open here, union, negative 4 to 1. Again, union and open because the 1 is not taken. And then 1, 2 plus infinity. Let's look at another example. Example number four. let fx equal 1 over absolute value of x minus 4. Again, the same question. Let's find the values that makes the denominator equal to 0. Solve. There are two values that makes the denominator equal to 0. Therefore, they have got to be excluded. Number line first. The smallest one on the left, the largest one on the right. Open circle to exclude them. So we will take all real numbers except negative 4 plus 4. In interval notation, it will be written like this. Union 4, 2 plus infinity. So this interval is here, this interval is here, this interval is here, and the union between them. Example 5, let fx equal 1 over x2 plus x plus 5. Let's see, let's find what the values of x that makes the denominator equal to 0. This is a quadratic equation. It doesn't look like it's easy to factor, so let's use the discriminant delta equal to b squared, which is 1 here, minus 4a, 1, c, 5. That gives you 1 minus 20, that gives you minus negative 19. The discriminant is less than 0, therefore this equation has no real solutions. If there are no real values of x that makes the denominator equal to 0, there is no problem. The domain is the set of all real numbers. Thank you.